spray in oil, oil the pan. Cheapy rice mix. It's like a dollar at Walmart. There's 2 cups of water. Another 1 1/3 cups of water. Bring that to a boil. While that's boiling, I'm going to chop up a little bit of broccoli to add into it. And I use the stems. I just chop them up finer. So that's just 1 head of broccoli, and I'm gonna got a couple green onions that I'm gonna toss in too. So I've cooked it till almost all the water is off of there, so I'm going to steam the broccoli and green onions in with my rice, and while that's cooking, I'm going to open up a can of black beans and add that in. So this is about a pound of hamburger. I'm just gonna cook this down. Just brown it. I'm gonna add in some salt. And pepper. Pepper. I'm or sister sire sauce, or however you want to say it. Liam Herring. Just about a teaspoon or two. Paprika? Chili powder. Notice I don't measure much of anything. I eyeball everything. So, chili powder, paprika, salt, pepper, to taste. And just cook that down. Sometimes I toss in some cumin. However, the Mexican rice packets have cumin in them, so I'm not gonna overdo it. I love using cast iron for everything. Nonstick pan. As long as it's seasoned right, it'll stay nonstick and you can do everything in them. So you don't want to overcook your meat and make a crust crunchy. You just want to make sure that there's no more pink in it. And it looks like I'm good. Chop up the bigger chunks just to check into it. So now I'm going to transfer my meat, not the grease and oil underneath, over to my rice and mix it in. So, kind of a strange thing here. I knew nothing about these. One of my best friends showed me this trick. You take your white flour tortilla, toss it on the burner, and you toast it over your burner. After about 30 seconds, you'll flip it. So, it cooks it all the way through. It adds kind of a toasted char flavor to it. And then it's done. You go to the next one.
but it's hot.
Okay, now I'm going to put them together. I'm going to use a little bit of feta cheese. It doesn't take much. Feta is a very strong cheese, so it doesn't take much for these smaller tortilla shells. And you see that they're all toasted. I'm cutting the bigger chunks in half just because it'll spread a little better. Make them even. All right, there's my feta. Then like a scoop or two of my hot mixture. A dollop of daisy. So, I like black olives a lot too. So you can either just slice them in half and put them on, like so, or you can take your can, nifty little hack here, and you can chop them up inside the can by running your knife around just back and forth, and you will cut them all up so that they spread evenly on your taco mixture. And I'm just going to do this real quickly. Grab a couple. All right. A little bit of salsa. Overpower anything. Avocado goes really good with this, but I don't have any. I'll take it side to side like this. Fold it a little ways in with the sides. And then roll it all the way over. Press down and kind of pull back. Okay? Tuck in the sides just a little bit. Roll it. Perfect rolled burrito. And you do that with the next ones. All right, put them on a plate and serve them. We'll see you next time. If you like this video, like and subscribe. Thank you. Bye. Have fun.